الحمد لله الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده على من لا نبي بعده ولا أمة بعد أمته ولا كتاب بعد كتابه ولا شريعة بعد شريعته أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وقضى ربك ألا تعبدوا إلا إياه وبالوالدين إحسانا إما يبلغن عندك الكبر أحدهما أو كلاهما فلا تقل لهما أف ولا تنهرهما وقل لهما قولا كريما صدق الله العظيم. Respected viewers, welcome back once again to our program Rays of Light, where we look at various and different themes from the Holy Quran. Yesterday, we mentioned the rights of parents and what Allah has mentioned about parents in the Holy Quran. Firstly, we said it's a style of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has adopted by first speaking about the rights of Allah, many a times using the word ittaqu. Whenever Allah mentions rights towards fellow human beings, ittaqu rabbakum alladhi khalaqakum min nafsin wahidah, fear Allah who created you from one single entity, Adam alayhi salam, then created for him his spouses, وَخَلَقَ مِنْهَا زَوْجَهَا وَبَثَّ مِنْهُمَا رِجَالًا كَثِيرًا وَنِسَاءً. From then one couple came the entire humanity till the day of Qiyamah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made mention of that. وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ الَّذِي تَسَاءَلُونَ بِهِ وَالْأَرْحَامِ, fear Allah with regard to the rights that come out of the womb. That means our blood relatives. Why fear Allah? Fear Allah with regard to this. With regard to your relationship, because that is also part of deen. And remember, Allah will hold you accountable for those type of relationships. Then we said about the rights of parents, the similar type of theme. Anishkur li wali walidayk. Be grateful to me, be grateful to your parents. Allah has commanded and decreed, worship no one besides Allah and be kind to your parents. By this kindness to parents is such, Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was asked, what are the rights of the parents upon their children? What did Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said? In Arabic, it is three words, but it covers the entirety of what the children are supposed to do towards their parents. He said, as he was blessed with eloquence of speech, he said, Huma jannatuka wa naruk. They are your jannat and jahannam. Subhanallah, just three words. Your parents are your Jannat or your Jahannam. They are your heaven or your hell. Treat them well, be kind to them, they become the means of heaven. And otherwise, they become the means of your Jahannam. Especially in old age. You would recall yesterday we said, Imma yablughanna indaka al-kibar. If one or both of your parents become old, do not even say uff to them in disrespect or in contempt. Okay? And Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, may that person be humbled and disgraced and humiliated who find one or both of his parents in old age and fails to gain Jannah by serving them. So Allah Ta'ala also says, فَلَا تَقُلْ لَهُمَا أُفْ. Surah Bani Israel, 15th Supara of the Holy Quran. فَلَا, don't even say uff to them in disrespect. Ali radiallahu ta'ala used to say, if there was a word lesser than uff that could have caused offense to parents, Allah would have made mention of that. Don't even say uff. In today's time, many a times this uff is like how children tell their parents, ah, don't even say uff to them. وَلَا تَقُلْ لَهُمَا uff. وَلَا تَنْهَرْهُمَا, don't scold or rebuke them. They are not your children, you are the child. فَلَا تَقُلْ لَهُمَا وَلَا تَنْهَرْهُمَا وَقُلْ لَهُمَا قَوْلًا كَرِيمًا. Speak to them in honorable and respectable terms. Speak to them with honor. Don't address them in a way that is not appropriate. وَخْفِضْ لَهُمَا جَنَاحَ الذُّلِّ, and submit yourself to them in humility. وَخْفِضْ لَهُمَا جَنَاحَ الذُّلِّ مِنَ الرَّحْمَةِ, out of mercy. don't do so. Don't do so. And submit yourself to them in humility because you wish to gain something from them. Minar rahma, out of mercy do so. And then whenever you make dua for them in these beautiful words that Allah has chosen and has taught us. Rabbi rahamhuma kama rabbayani saghira. Oh Allah, have mercy upon them the way they had mercy upon us when we were in our infancy. When a child is small, the parents will sacrifice anything for the sake of the child. They will sacrifice their sleep, their comfort, everything. So Allah is telling you, you make dua. Oh Allah, have mercy upon them the way they had mercy upon us when we were little. Subhanallah. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in another place has made mention with regard to the rights of mother in particular. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Luqman has also said a beautiful aspect with regard to the rights of parents. Right? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Anishkur li wa li walidayk ilayya al-masir wa in jahadaka ala an tushrika bi ma laysa laka bihi ilm fala tuti'huma. You see, there is only one being's obedience that is supreme and unconditional, right? And that is the commands and obedience to Allah. Everyone's else obedience is subject to it being according to the commands of Allah. So Allah Ta'ala says, if the parents or anyone for that matter were to command you to do something that is against the commands of Allah, فَلَا تُتِعْهُمَا, don't obey them. So even if the parents were to tell you to do something against the commands of Allah, or the way the ayat in Surah Luqman says, if they tell you that you must associate partners to Almighty Allah, فَلَا تُطِعْهُمَا, do not follow them, but وَسَاحِبُمَا فِي الدُّنْيَا مَعْرُوفًا, still be kind and considerate to them. Even if they tell you to do something that is wrong, don't obey them in that, but still be kind, considerate and compassionate to them. So even if your parents are non-Muslim from another faith, the Quran tells us in this verse that you must be good to them. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the 26th supara of the Holy Quran in Surah Ahqaf, Allah ta'ala specifically makes mention of the mother. وَوَصَّيْنَا الْإِنسَانَ بِوَالِدَيْهِ إِحْسَانًا حَمَلَتْهُ أُمُّهُ كُرْهًا وَوَضَعَتْهُ كُرْهًا. The mother bore and the mother gave birth, weaned you with great difficulty. Look at the three things. Therefore, Nabi Karim sallallahu alaihi wasallam was asked, who has the greatest right upon a human being? Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, your mother. Then Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam was asked, who next, ya Rasulullah? Your mother. Who next, ya Rasulullah? Your mother. Then Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, your father. Allah specifically makes mention of the rights of mother after the general command to be good to your parents. وَسَّيْنَا الْإِنسَانَ بِوَالِدَيْهِ إِحْسَانًا حَمَلَتْهُ أُمُّهُ كُرْهًا وَوَضَعَتْهُ كُرْهًا. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mention of the mother. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us a tawfiq of being kind and considerate to our parents. If our parents are alive, respected viewers, value them. Show them respect and honor. Be kind and considerate. And if our parents have passed on, let us make dua for them. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala elevate their status, forgive their shortcomings, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant them peace and tranquility in the qabr and in the year after. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين.